Hey guys, it's Miss Butler. I wanted to do a little bit of practice with some of our vocabulary words for this week. These are four of our vocab words, and I just wanted to show you guys some sample sentences. I know usually if we were together, we would be filling in the blank with some sample sentences, so I wanted to make sure we still had some good examples of these words in sentences. So let's start with maverick. Okay, this word means an independent person. And remember, a synonym means the same. So it means the same thing as someone that's an individual or an individualist or someone that is a nonconformist. Non means not, right? And conform means to go along. So this is someone that does not go along with what everyone else is doing. And here's our sample sentences. The company's president was a bit of a maverick, ignoring the recommendations of his advisors. So this president is not doing, right, what the advisors are telling him to do, even though that's their job. So he's being described as a little bit of a maverick because he's kind of doing his own thing. He's not conforming and he's being very independent. The second sentence says, although all of his closest friends joined the high school band, Jim decided instead to join the chess team. So this is a case where all, you know, everyone that he's hanging around is doing one thing, but he's kind of going to do what he wants to do. Like, he's not going to give in to any of that peer pressure because he wants to not be in the band, but to play chess. So he's just maybe a little different than the rest of his friends in this area of his life. Okay, then the next one. Oh, I did too many. Esoteric. Let's get rid of that one for now. Esoteric is known or understood by only a select few. So this is something, it could be a subject, it could be a joke, it can be anything that only some people understand or only some people know. The synonym is that it's like secretive, or maybe it's difficult, so not many people understand it. Or maybe it's really deep, like really profound. I think of mathematics. Some upper level math is esoteric to me, that's for sure. Okay, so maverick is a noun, right? Because it's a person. Esoteric actually is an adjective because it's going to describe something. So you tell me, look at this first sentence. What is it describing? Unlike other professors, Margaret was very familiar with esoteric literature from the Middle Ages. Esoteric is before what now? Literature, right? So it's describing that this literature, these, you know, stories or plays or whatever it is she's reading, might be kind of hard because they're from the Middle Ages. And so she's the only one that can understand them. Even other professors who, you know, we think of as being pretty smart people, they don't understand them either. So this type of work that she's reading is esoteric. And then the next one, Eric made an esoteric joke that only he and his brother understood. So this is kind of like an inside joke, right? It's just a secret kind of between them. No one else understands what he's making fun of. Okay, let's go to the next one. Whoops. Okay, what is going on, guys? Sorry. Let's try that again. Okay, undermine. To undermine is something someone does. So if it's a doing word, right, it's a verb, right? It's an action word, and it means to weaken. And usually it's gradually. It might not happen immediately. And it might be injuring or destroying something secretly. So undermine usually means someone is up to no good trying to weaken something, and it might be behind the scenes. The synonyms are to disable it, to undercut it, or even to sabotage. That means it might be done on purpose a lot of the times. Okay, let's look at these example sentences. Chloe hoped that her allergies were not going to undermine her ability to perform in the recital. Okay, in this situation, you know, her allergies aren't, you know, a person, so they're definitely not trying to sabotage her, but they do fit the first definition, right, of weakening, right? Or kind of injuring in some way her ability to perform. So maybe she's like, you know, blowing her nose a lot or coughing or whatever. Her eyes are watering because of her allergies. And she's afraid that she's not going to sing as well as she usually does. I can relate, Chloe. I can relate. Okay. And then the second sentence says, to undermine her opponent's confidence, Vanessa started shouting a war whoop every time she served the ball. Okay, so Vanessa apparently is playing volleyball, and she thinks that the people she's playing against are feeling pretty confident. So what she do? She wants to undermine their confidence. She wants to weaken their confidence. She wants to destroy their confidence. And so she kind of is a little bit of sabotage, right? Because that's kind of her enemy, and she's trying to win the game. Okay, and let's do one more, and that'll be all for today. Alleviate. Okay, alleviate is also a verb, right? I can say to alleviate. Look at these action words. It means relieve, lessen, or make more bearable. So some words that are similar is like ease, or to lighten, or to reduce. So this first sentence, I think, is the one I always think of first when I think of the word alleviate, and it is take an aspirin to alleviate your headache. So we take an aspirin so that our headache is lessened, right? It's not as bad. It's more bearable. I'm relieved of it. It goes away. So now you might know why some headache medicine is called Aleve. Oh, there we go. And then the last sentence says, one local factory will alleviate the town's job shortage by providing 250 more jobs. Okay, so this factory has opened up in town. It's gonna give 250 jobs, which means that it's going to alleviate, right? Or lessen, literally decrease here, right? The town's job shortage. There's gonna be more jobs. Okay, so those are our words. Maverick, a noun, esoteric, an adjective, and then two verbs, undermine and alleviate. All right, make sure you're doing your homework activities. They are due Thursday, and keep studying these words because we will be writing sentences for our quiz on Friday. Have an awesome day.